I now want to turn my attention, though, to a guest who's calling in, and he's a very interesting person. His name is David Hardy. He is CEO of Boys Latin of Philadelphia, an all-boys Philadelphia charter school. He's spokesman for PhillySchoolChoice.com. That's PhillySchoolChoice.com, which is a campaign to bring together groups of parents and taxpayers who believe that school choice should be a reality for all families in Philadelphia. Their mission is not to advocate for passage of a particular law or policy change, but rather to build a coalition of like-minded supporters who believe it's time to move beyond a one-size-fits-all model for public education. Welcome, and thanks for being with us. Tell me, what is PhillySchoolChoice.com?
PhillySchoolChoice.com is, like you said, it's an effort to get people who are interested in the expansion of school choice together. Taxpayers, parents, people who want to see more and varied options, more quality options for students and families in Philadelphia.
And who is, what is the opposition you face? I mean, obviously you're advocating for charter schools, for all different kinds of school options for kids. You're against the one-size-fits-all public school. So who's opposing this effort that you're leading or that you're heavily involved in?
Well, it is the people who benefit from the one-size-fits-all situation. If you look at it, in this country, if you have resources, you have choice. So if you want, you can put your child in a private school. You can move into a school district where you think the schools are good. You can pay for tutoring. You have ways of making sure your child gets a better education. But if you don't have resources and you're stuck in the local public schools, if you live on 8th Street, you have to go to the 8th Street school. No matter whether your brothers and sisters failed in that school, your parents, maybe even your grandparents did poorly in that school, because you live on 8th Street, you have to go to the 8th Street school. And the people who are advocating that are the people who work at the 8th Street school, because they know that if you had a choice, you wouldn't go there. So this is kind of a situation where the people who really need to get out are stuck, because there's people saying, this is my job, instead of, I'm going to make this school better. You have to take it no matter how it is. And that's just patently unfair. And what really is unfair about it are the people who work in these places and the people who advocate for these places would never send their children to that school. They all have other options, but they're advocating to keep poor people trapped in failing schools, and that is not fair.
I tell you what, I so completely agree with you. What an injustice in our society that we are, and it's such a funny thing too that not to put labels on it, but a lot of times liberals and you know, people like John Kerry is one, you know, very, very, very wealthy guy, Secretary of State now, former liberal senator from Massachusetts. And he's to me is, you know, kind of personifies the kind of person who's liberal. Oh yeah, we're trying to help poor people. And yet the Democrat Party is all about the unions who are representing the people working in the schools. And they want to prop up these sort of one-size-fits-all schools, and it keeps all the poor people they say they're representing down. It's another example where the liberal policy, the result is the exact opposite of the stated intent. The intent is to try to help poor people. Oh, yeah, we want to help poor people with these policies, with public schools, et cetera. But then the reality is that it keeps people down, and it's wrong.
Well, you know, it's interesting. There is a group called Democrats for Choice, and there are, a number of Democrats who've come out in favor of school choice and who are very active in favor of school choice. And they become pariahs in their party. they become pariahs in the party. People hate them for that one thing. They can toe the party line, everything else. But if they say they're against, if they're for school choice, people really start to resent them. And that's an amazing thing. It looks like there is a group in this country who are against progress, who are against pulling people, you know, having people improve themselves through the educational system, which is how many of us that was our only chance of improving ourselves and our family situation.
Yes.
I'm a son of a single mother. I grew up in North Philadelphia, and I had public school choice growing up because school district wasn't completely bad at that point. There were places, there were pockets where you could go, and there was, you know, schools that you could go to, and my mom made sure that I got into those schools. And without that, I don't know where I'd be today. But when you look at a single mom in North Philly nowadays, she's getting a lot of pressure to keep her kid in that failing school district, in the failing neighborhood school. And that's going to keep opportunity from happening for a lot of children.
Yeah, yeah. What percentage of Philadelphia kids are in alternative schools, in charter schools, or some kind of alternative school?
Well, we know that there's 200,000 total public school students. About a third of them are in charter schools. But there's also a number of kids who are in private schools and parochial schools, you know, religious schools.
Yes.
That's a whole other group of people. And then when you want to talk about, you know, why Philadelphia loses people, the number of people who move when their children become school age, you know, that's another big number. And in the old days, we used to call that white flight. Well, that flight is very, that's a very diverse flight now.
Now it's a diverse flight, right? Because anybody who's,
that's right.
It's basically middle class flight. It's middle and upper middle class flight.
That's right. Anybody who can get out goes.
Anybody, and that isn't, think about that. Think about that reality of American city life. If you're a mom and dad and you have children you care about, anybody who can get out, can get their children out, goes. It's just, it's
right.
That, and
it's a sad situation.
It is so sad.
And here's where the problem is. People look at the concept, and you know, I'm a big fan of a guy named Howard Fuller, who is a real big choice advocate around the country, former superintendent of Milwaukee, and a professor at Marquette University. And Howard explains it like this. The concept of public education is that. It's just a concept. The school system is a delivery system. There are other ways to deliver public education, but the school district is one of them. And that is an economic entity. Now, you know, when you hear people talk about increasing school choice, charter schools and whatever, they talk about the privatization and the corporatization of public education. Well, public education is already a big business. What we're arguing about is who controls the business. Do the people who run, who work there control it? Or does the customer control it? Like most other businesses, do you have to address a market and make sure that market is attracted to what you have to offer? And that's the fight here. It's not about will we spend money on public education? Will people be employed doing public education? All those things will never change. But what will change is who controls the product. And the product is normally dictated by the customer, by the market, except in inner city public education.
Well, David Hardy, and you're with them. Boy, to talk a little bit about your school. You run Boys Latin?
Yes, we're so Pennsylvania's only single-gender charter school. And what we do is we have boys in middle and high school. And they come in, and we have a very strict environment with uniforms and strict code of conduct. We're rigorous. I mean, it's a Latin school, and that Latin means everybody learns Latin. The sixth graders get something called prima lingua, which is a pre-Latin preparation course. But from seventh grade on, you get Latin. And high school is 4 years of Latin, mandatory. We have an extended day. We go till 5 o'clock. Today is our first day of Saturday school. If you're not doing well, if your grades are below passing, Saturday school is mandatory. We're about making sure that people make progress. We're demanding that people work hard and make progress, but we also provide a lot of support. The teachers are there on Saturday to help guys who are struggling in class. And what that means is that we can produce better results. We have a 97% graduation rate. We have the third highest college matriculation rate in the city. Now, in Philadelphia, they have, in the high schools, they have selective admission schools, and there's like 30 or 25 or 30 selective admission schools where you have to be in the top 5 or 10% of all public school students to go to those schools.
Yeah.
We beat everyone but two of those. And the two are, one is the top high school of the state, Masterman, the other one, I think, is number three. And we're only a few points behind that school as far as college matriculation rate. 84% of our boys go to college. That's not admissions rate. Our admissions rates are pretty, are much higher. They're in the high 90s. Last year, we had 100% admissions rate. But that's not the number you want to look at. You want to look at who goes to college. And that number is provided by something called the National Student Clearinghouse.
Yeah.
And in 2013, the last numbers that came out for the city of Philadelphia, we were number three. And that was only our third graduating class. We started out at number nine. We moved up to number three in 3 years of our existence.
Well, David, we're running out of time, unfortunately. I'm adding you. I tell you what, I have two heroes this morning. One is Mark Vaughn, who came out and saved the second woman in the parking lot in Moore, Oklahoma yesterday. But you're my second hero today. You just sound we've never met in person. I heard great things about you before we set up this interview. And I tell you what, next time I'm in Philadelphia, I'm going to come see Boys Latin School. It sounds terrific.
Please come. I love to show you the school. And I want to say one thing before I get off, and that is, if you're a parent or anyone interested in public education in Philly and expanding choice, expanding options for children, please get on phillyschoolchoice.com and give us your information so that we can put together a coalition of caring people and make opportunity for everybody.
David Hardy, CEO of Boys Latin in Philadelphia. Thanks for being here.
Thank you very much.
Glen Meakem on the weekend. We'll be right back.